Traditionally, when people have tried to make education videos, they always assume that the quality needs to be in the production, that you need computer graphics, big budget. And I don't know for sure, but what I think the reason why Khan Academy has gotten this traction, and even in a world where some of this has already existed, these fancier videos, is that people felt that they were real. People felt that it was a real connection with a real person, and that was really trying to help their cousin, and they could tell, they could feel that through the video. There will be some videos that are higher produced, but I think there will always be a piece of what we do, which is a teacher who's excited about what they're doing, passionate, respect for the student, and can teach it in a way that gives the student intuition and excitement. But what happens in education is kind of like what happens with fashion, that the people who make the jeans will send their jeans to Jennifer Lopez hoping that she'll put them on. And then she puts them on and you get a picture, then everyone starts wearing those jeans. And so we see the same thing in education, that if a very good school adopts a practice, then the other schools that say, hey, we're pretty good too, they adopt the practice as well. The universities are changing quickly. I'm sure a lot of y'all know that Harvard, MIT, Stanford, they're starting to put their courses out there. And their intent is, one, it's an altruistic intent to share their knowledge. But there's a whole other dimension where they too agree that, yeah, why are we having students sit in 300-person lecture halls and then they just take notes? We want them to interact. So I think when you see a Harvard stop giving lectures and it's all interaction, then Yale will say, yeah, we're not going to give lectures either. Stanford will say that, and then you'll see universities do it, high schools will do it. But once again, it's not going to be overnight. It'll be 10, 15 years before it's fully mainstream.